Put your cards on the table, bitch.
G'day guys, it's the Eccentric Magpie here, filming a short video tonight to have a look at Joffa's red carpet and his movie premiere. I'm on the platform here at Eltham, my hometown. There's plenty of people have been talking about it, radio, internet exposure as well, and I'm just about positive it's going to be fucking hilarious, Joff. So good luck to you, mate, and I'm really jealous because, I mean, I've been doing videos for ages and they're not going fucking anywhere.
Exclusive premiere of Joffa The Movie at the Kino here at Collingwood. What do you think about that?
I'm so amped. I'm so amped.
Get the red carpet.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to it. Get these people. We haven't paid these people to come here. They're paid to be here. And this is Pearl.
This is Pearl.
Say hello. Hello. And that's Dutchy. That's my security man.
G'day, yeah.
I want to tell, I read in the paper earlier in the week that you had a bit of a rough life in the building.
Yes.
And you have turned yourself around. How did you go about that, mate?
When you get to a certain age, you realise what's right and what's wrong. You either go down the bad road or the good road. I decided very early on to go down the good road. Yeah. And not to blame my upbringing on anything that might have gone wrong. Yeah. My upbringing was an adventure, and I loved it.
Do you think the Pies are in a better place position than 2003 to take home the cup?
I do. This is the best Collingwood side I've seen in my lifetime, by a country mile, by an absolute country mile, and they're only travelling at 70%. I'm tipping that the next 3 weeks they're going to put their foot down and they probably get near them. And I say that with confidence, not hoping that it's going to rain. I'm not hoping that the opposition are going to get injuries. I'm saying that because this side is good. Yeah. And if they don't make it to the grand final, it'll be a bloody disaster. But they'll get there. And if they do get there, they'll win it.
Awesome. Now, if we didn't take home the cup, do you reckon Eddie's head might pop off?
No, not at all. No, Ed saved this pop off. Interesting terminology. No, Ed saved. Look, Ed saved this football club. Yeah. We wouldn't be where we are now if it wasn't for Eddie McGuire.
Yeah, that's right.
Public screening of Joffa The Movie, and the main man himself is about to walk down the red carpet. Joffa!
The official poster. Just heading down the red carpet, just another day. Pretty mad sea of black and white there.
Decent turnout, man.
It is a decent turnout, definitely, yeah. Me and Jazz were just talking about Joffa's bodyguard. He seemed like a pretty tense dude.
Pretty big dude.
That's right, he was a big unit, that's for sure.
At least 6 foot eight.
Yeah.
6 foot seven, 6 foot eight.
Oh yeah, we're talking the beanstalk out of Jack and the Beanstalk. It's pretty damn tall. Jazz, I think you need to say something.
Put comments down there.
That's right.
The comments go.
That's right. Representing the comment box below. Some mad pre-tunes. Everyone getting amped.
So please go home and tell all your friends and people at school, hey, it's a good laugh, but it's a feel-good movie. That's all we want you to do.
Josh. Now, here we've got the co-host of the movie tonight, Joffa, and his co-host, Shane, as well. Yeah, I've just got a few things to ask, boys. You have your fair share of haters, Joffa, but by now you'd be used to the insults, am I right?
Absolutely. Sometimes I like being insulted. It's like people like being spat on. Oh, well, you stick up with me now, are you?
Me and my friend. Now, the thing I love about this dynamic duo here is that they always stay in character. I had a question for yourself, Shane.
Because he's a dumb... He's a
fucking... dipstick. Is it half real life, half just for the movie, that character that you put on?
Yeah. They said that they were looking for someone to play my kind of a character when we were in a group of people. And then in 20 seconds, all the eyes were looking at me. So basically, went from there. So.
Fantastic.
Well, I like your stuff on YouTube.
That was actually my next question, Joff. I wanted to know what you actually thought of my videos.
Very funny stuff, but I don't know why you are not on TV yet.
Really? Well, I'm really impressed to hear that, mate. Now, Joff, it's a bit overwhelming to be in the position that you're in,
no,
from essentially zero to hero, mate.
Oh, no, not overwhelming. No, not I mean, no. I have nothing. I'm a man of nothing that walks amongst the people. That's my story. I have no ego, I have no riches, I have nothing. I have a beautiful family. He promised me, 2 years ago outside a cafe in Coburg, promised me $1 million in the world if we hit this movie.
That was Chris.
And you were with him, you were partners in crime.
And he promised me the same thing.
And premiere night, and look at this. This is my wallet. $50,000 is all I got in my wallet. 2 years of hard work, premiere night. That, and this man here, Christopher Tissa, him promised me everything.
Can you recall the most memorable moments as a Vice fan looking on in the stands?
Yes, I think the most memorable moment would be out of Waverley Park when there was a series of handballs against West Coast Eagle on the boundary line, which resulted in Davis kicking a goal, I think that the handball was the ground by Dacos, goal. Yeah,
Sean, I had a question for yourself, mate. Who did Joffa approach you, or who actually approached you to have a role in the movie?
Chris, mainly. Chris sort of came up with the product, I suppose you'd say.
Well, it worked out fine, mate. I think we all got a few kicks out of your character, that's for sure.
If you want to watch a good movie, you just have people laugh, feel good about life, go see this movie.
Two hours ago, I was actually feeling quite stressed, but I saw that.
It's like a calming effect.
That's right, you know.
That $500 electricity bill sitting on the table at home isn't as bad as what it was when you walked in here.
That's right.
I know what it's like.
Yeah, state of zen, you know, state of zen. Where to from here, mate? Is there going to be another film, or is there going to be a variety show going on Channel 9?
We're off to Los Angeles.
Off to LA.
You're back to cutting boards.
We had fun doing this. We didn't take this thing seriously.
No, we didn't. Look, at the end of the day, it was always going to be, you know, we always knew it wasn't going to be a blockbuster or anything. If you want to have a bit of a laugh, go and check out Joffa the Movie, guys. Here's
Patchy Poos from the Herald Sun. What's his last name?
Lee Pace.
It's Lee Pace from the Herald Sun. He's chasing us around town, assassinating us. It's a fun movie, lighten up. Get a grip.
So it's meant to be.
Life's short. So what, Mr. Pace? It got to the cinema. Get over it. People will love it. Move on. Move on from your hatred towards us.
We heard it from the horse's mouth there. That was Joffa and his co-star Shane. Thanks for the interview, fellas.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
Thank you. Make sure he doesn't run away
out
of the camera.
G'day, guys. Here I am at the Maroondra Reservoir, as you can see there. Last night, we've just been to the Joffa the Movie premiere. I can say it's a lovely feel-good movie, and Joff has done great things with his co-star Shane, and I really recommend you go out and see it. Hopefully he's going to follow it up with maybe a TV show or something, or maybe me and yourself, Joff, we could partner up and do our own little side project.